Okay, we're gonna do a Fortnite video, try to get a dub. If we don't, we're gonna go on Team Rumble, okay? Ding, ding, dong, ding, dong. Ding, dong. Ding, dong, ding, dong. That holds. Yes, it will.
I just told you that you do not have even a civil case against her, but I wouldn't take my little 3-pound Shih Tzu to a dog park because you never know. And you never know when a dog is going to feel threatened or when my dog will become what I deem friendly, some other dog would find annoying. You chose to do that. It was your choice.
I got so Frankie.
I would assume that if you're an intelligent person, you will not take your dog back
homeless
to the doormat. And if you post nasty things about her on Facebook, which I actually believe that you did, although you deleted them, somebody said to you, you better delete those things, it's not the right thing to do, since actually she was not in the law. She tried to help you. She carried your dog to the car. It was a nice thing for her to do because she felt some sort of a responsibility to you. It wasn't her legal responsibility, but she felt a human responsibility. And your reaction was
inappropriate.
Chad, to say the
least, your case is
dismissed.
My dog was severely injured and is now traumatized by this event. And you take a dog to a community dog park, take the risk. No more doggy play dates, for sure. No more doggy play dates and no more cyberbullying. That's not fair.
And now, the next case.
All parties in the matter of Shelley Lonin versus Santiago. Step forward.
Angela Shelley and her mother, Ellen Lonin, are suing Angela's ex-boyfriend, Edwin Santiago, for towing her car while driving her three children.
Miss Shelley, this is your mom, and this is your
Rito,
former boyfriend,
Rito,
and you
the
also
mega
have one child together.
Yes, sir.
You have two other children.
Yes, sir.
This is your mom. You and the defendant live together with your one child together and your two children.
Game's so laggy, and if we don't,
you bought a car. Your mother co-signed for the loan on the car. And you and the defendant, and now I'm filling in the blanks. You and the defendant used this car.
What is this?
And when you bought that car and you had a loan on the car, you were required to the terms of the loan to maintain an insurance policy against collision on the car. Mr. Santiago took the children out one day while you were working and had an accident with the car. The car was totaled.
Yes,
for some reason, your insurance that you were supposed to have didn't cover the loss. So now you bring this case here for me to find him responsible for the totaling of your car. That's what the case is about.
Yes, ma'am.
So let's get back to why you didn't have insurance.
Well,
is not an answer.
When I initially got the car, I had insurance. At the time of the accident, my insurance had less.
That's your fault. That doesn't mean he's responsible for your totaled car. That means you're responsible because you let the insurance lapse.
Even with the insurance, he was not on the policy, so he wouldn't cover it anyway. Because at the time of the accident, he had a permit.
Listen to me. We both know that he drove that car with you in it, with the children, without insurance, and if he only had a permit, with a permit, because he was watching the children at home. You were working that day. Am I all correct about this, sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Even so, that day he did not have permission to take the children to the state park where he took them.
Gang isn't seeing me no more. I like that shadow.
Closed captioning sponsored by.
To tell me you want me to believe this very intelligent person right here that this man asked you permission to take the children to the park every time he wanted to take the children out? He was watching them at home.
No, but to consent, he would normally consent to taking them out when he was driving my vehicle.
Yeah, you mean he slept with you at night and asked you if he could drive a car that he helped pay for?
I paid for it.
Just a second. Who was making the payments on the car?
I wasn't.
Were you working?
Yes, ma'am.
He didn't pay any payments for the car.
Just a second. Who paid the rent?
I did.
So he paid for nothing. When he was working, you let him live with you and take all his money and put it in his pocket.
No, when he could help out,
he would. Could help out. What kind of work did he do?
He was doing line work at a bakery.
No,
it was only for.
How long were you working at a bakery?
I was working there for 5 months, I got laid off due to transportation issues. Upon receiving a car, I got rehired. So I was working for 4 months by the time of the accident. 4 more months by the time of the accident.
And how much money did you make a week?
It was roughly between $550 to $750, depending on overtime and hours and stuff like that.
And what did you do with your money?
Whatever needed to be filled in, whatever she asked for, I gave.
Like what?
Rent, electricity, light.
How did you give her the money?
The truth is this. If my paycheck came up to $556, I took $56 and gave her $500.
That's what I think. That's
not true.
Listen to me. You played house, you both worked. He was watching the kids. There was a car accident. You let the insurance lapse. That doesn't mean that he's responsible. Do you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. Goodbye. Good job.
Always up. Next step out. Judge to be continued. Sit up. And on the next judge to be.
I took him too. Come on, Dennis! Get the ball. We get the ball. Andre, with the ball. Cross the leg. Crossover. Behind the back. Passes to Dennis. Curry off the cut. Curry! In Asia P. It's 2-0. I'm going to tell you the score. But I'm not going to tell you, maybe.
In a full
blocked it. Going down the court and slams it. He tells him how to make it. Doesn't get blocked. Doesn't get blocked. Doesn't. How do you type on the viewers, though? How do you type on the viewers? Paul Pierce. That's Paul Pierce. I'm sick. What are your names? Gang
shoot.
I just know that we get great. 9-4. We're whooping their butt by 5. Straight up 5.
2K18. I'm gonna put no title piece
of show in 2K18.
To the series that has added a little bit of everything. These two Western Conference
heavyweights,
the Warriors and the Rockets.
Oh!
NBA. Rockets tonight facing elimination. The Warriors without Kevin Durant looking to close their 5th consecutive trip.
I'm gonna go ahead and call him the next one.
Game 6 is next.
I'm on a mission, mission.
Can you guys see this? Blah! city, bruh. We block your nose, bruh.
Utah gains 3-4 in this series against Golden State.
Kelly.
Curry has been marvelous in this series against Houston. Fans like Curry deflects Curry's way to Bogut. Bogut misses three for two. And he's in the game on three relishes. He's had an outstanding series. Look at his impact across the board, rebounding, assist, scoring the basketball, an incredible defense. Well, game six in the first round, he had a triple-double to eliminate the Clippers. Well, she had another foul for three throws. This one on Curry. First foul on Steph Curry. The Rockets, the entire series. The offensive rebounding, the Golden State Warriors led by Draymond Green.
Truly been a great predictor and indicator of who ultimately was going to come out and win. Both teams at home have been terrific on the boards, not so much on the road.
James Harden with his second missed free throw. Normally an outstanding free throw shooter. All right, so far in these playoffs, shooting at 87%. A little bit higher in this series.
Today, as a top-ranked UFC featherweight, Ortega uses the fighting spirit of Since 1825, we've proved that it doesn't matter where you come from. It matters what you're made of. Or don't. The official gear of U.S. City.
Chloe Jim's sunglasses were worn on the beaches of Hawaii. Designed to
respond to
the
bright sun
and harsh flare of the islands.
Ham and rice.
That's so stupid. Can you go get me heat rolls?
Still a part of everything we do. A polarized plus two lens
make me
protect eyes from harmful rays. They also
heat
make color vivid, contrast crisper.
Now, well, mom.
For yourself. The view's better from
here. Mm-hmm.